All right, so we're down to the last log. What I need to fill this order is a cant that's 7 1/8 by 7 1/8. We'll do a measurement here real quick. Looks like it's not gonna be a problem. Get the log up there, it's kind of dirty. It's not hitting the outside log stop, but I will fix that after I get a flat. So this way, go inside the bark, it's like 20, this way is about 22. You're going to have no problem getting 7 1/8 by 7 1/8. Matter of fact, we're probably going to be able to cut them an extra piece or a couple extra pieces so that they can see how they dry. So I'm going to skim the top. We're just going to try to get it into a cant right now at 20. If I call it 20, the cant's going to work out to 14 inches. So I'm looking to get a 14 inch cant. Just keep my lumber crayon and we're going to center the pith if we can. Because if I give them extra wood, this is going to double pith on this end. So it's going to be hard to figure out, but it's basically at 13 off this board. And we'll check this end. It's at 13. So the pith is centered right now. We're gonna get a 14 by 14. So somewhere about right there. And that is up. Let's just say 19 plus this. I think this is probably, yes, 1 inch. So we gotta come down 20 inches, cut the top off it. And that's gonna give us about 14 side to side. And then we'll go from there. So we're gonna take this off at 20 inches. There's a little bit of dirt in this log. Oh, I found my other tape measure. I don't know what that, it must've been behind something. We got two tapes back now. So we'll take it off at 20. That's gonna get rid of most of the dirt in this log and that'll get us started. coming. One more inch on me. Yeah, I cheated up a little bit. Thank you. on, which we are, our width needs to be 4 bodies. So 3, 6, 9, 10 and a half. We're gonna be 3 and a half. So 3, 6, 9, 10 and a half plus an 8. So 10 and 5/8, I can come up off the bottom. Let's see what that looks like on the backside. Should be 9, 10 and a half plus 2/8. So it should be 10 and 3/4, but I'm gonna show you what I do here. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna come up. I'm gonna get the dust off here. What we're doing is we're setting our width right now. Be able to cut 4 bodies out of it. So we're going to come down. Hopefully I fit it on here at 3 and a half. So 3 and a half. I don't fit. So the next cut will be at 7 and 8. So I'm going to cut that 3-inch piece off, then drop down to 7 and 8. No, I'm just taking that top one off at 3 inches and then flipping it on its side. So that'll work out to give me... it's going to give me 3 rows of 4x4s. I'll end up having plenty. So I'm going to go ahead and cut this right off at that. There's some dirt there I'm going to get rid of. Cut the perfect spot. right there. Should be able to cut this whole order today. See where we're at. It's gonna go a lot. That's too much. Okay, now how bad is the pith is the big question here. It's a double pith here, so there's no way we can check it. I think it just makes sense to cut it the way it is. Looks like the whole log needs to come up. There's... we need 10 3/4. So that's like at 16. It's going to be like at 15. I think we got plenty. We only need 10 3/4. This is 16 right now to the bottom of the pith. This is 19. That needs to come way up. That sucks. Now I'm going to have to re-square the whole thing. Roll the whole log 180 degrees. So what you got to do, and I can cut it out, but it's not going to be anywhere close to parallel to the pit, to the pith. I think we got to roll the whole thing 180 degrees so it's flatter. Get those
probably get those dogs up a little higher.
Definitely not going below that. 9. 9. Like this, see how this work looks. That's way flatter. Pretty square. Perfect. Perfect. Okay. All right. Now, that's way flatter there. We want to take it off to right in here. 18 here, probably close to 17. So let's do that. So this one, this end's a little fat. The log boat. This edge is perfectly straight. I'm gonna flip it on its side. I'm gonna cut this to 10 3/4, shave it, and then flip it up again, and then we should be able to mill it out and then turn them on this side, yeah. I think. Yep. So we're going to want to take this to throw it on its side. Could be a million reasons why. It looks like the log just bowed. Those are both at 9, so they're good. We'll do a skim cut at 10 3/4 and then flip it up and finish it off. two possible mantle chunks here, but we'll keep this one for a mantle chunk. Let's
see if I can carry it.
And I'll pick it off. I'll pick it off with the machine. Set it over here. Let me get you guys backed up. Then I'll cut those three. So I have two possibilities for the mantle, depending on how thick they want it. That one down there and that one. That's going to turn into 6 4-bys to go with those, just in case. Yeah, that looks good. And then they could take any stock they want out of that too. I'll charge them for it. But let's back you guys up. I'll come in, grab that, spin around, throw it on the floor, throw it on the sawhorses really quick. Exactly 3 4-by-4s in these. Right. Okay. Yeah, we'll throw these up. It's gonna give them two extra 4x4s. That means that they've got a mantle chunk, and we'll give them that mantle chunk. And if they end up with any, they're not gonna end up with problems with the 6x's. The two rails, who knows? These are gonna be the ones that are gonna most likely fall. They can just take the straightest ones. And the ones they like the color, the color's best. I think that, we'll measure that in a second. That might be a replacement for 6x's too. I didn't think of that. Beautiful old color, beautiful grain. So instead of six, I'm going to get eight of these. They can have the option of, if they don't want to pay for them, then they can bring them back. Let's see what the dimension is on that piece right there, because if it's six, if it's 5.5 and it's damn close. Let me shove it over. It could be a replacement for any, yeah, it is. So this is a replacement, a direct replacement for anything here. And then the other piece, I'll clean all this up tomorrow. Really, this could be the other mantelpiece. Nice. I'll show you what all it looks like. And I've got a couple of boards down in here anyway. But, so we got a monster mantle if they want that, elm. And that includes the pith. They have this mantle piece, which is like 3 inches thick. If they want that, it could be a natural edge mantle. They got the 2 6x6s. They wanted 6 4x4s. I'm giving them 8. And then 2 6x3s. Just make sure we get everything. Yeah, 2 6x6s. 2 3x6s. Yep, that's all of it. So, it's another order out the door. I'm going to send him a picture right now. He can come get it tomorrow when it's not raining. And I'm going to put everything to bed. I'll probably clean up the mill tomorrow. I'm not going to do it tonight. I'll blow it off, and I got to take the band off it so that it doesn't get dripped on and rusty. But yeah, that band did well. Those Woodmizer Silver Tip Turbo 7s from Day's Saw Bands. Those bands are nice. They really cut well. They cut flat. They cut fast. They stay sharp a long time. I mean, I'm not scraping these off to show you, but man, the grains are beautiful in these. It's gorgeous. So I'm going to send this to them, and I can see that, yeah, and everything's over length. So they got the whole thing over length, which is good. That works out. So they can use anything for anything. So Well, I'll make a video tomorrow repairing that chain for that 372 that I broke. So Pirate Solutions out.